Welcome to Maths Katta, my YouTube channel, Standard 10, Maths 2, Similarity. The property of three parallel lines and their transversal, this property we want to study now. The theorem for this property is the ratio of intercepts made on the transversal by three parallel lines is equal to the ratio of corresponding intercepts made on any other transversal by the same parallel lines. To prove this theorem, we require the three parallel lines and the two intercepts. The intercepts made on a transversal and any other transversal is given here. Therefore, we require two transversals and three parallel lines. Therefore, consider the figure of three parallel lines. Here, observe the figure. Line L is parallel to line M is parallel to line N. This is one transversal. This is another transversal. Give the name to these transversals as T1 and T2. They intersect these lines in points A, B, C and point P, Q, R respectively. This want to write in the given. Now what we want to prove, again observe the statement that the ratio of intercepts made on a transversal. Now what do you mean by intercepts? Intercept means, consider this is a transversal T1 which intersects line L, M, N in points A, B and C. The segment AB is called as an intercept. Also BC, segment BC is called as a intercepts. Now here the ratio of intercepts made on a transversal. Ratio means division. Therefore we want to consider the first left hand side of the to prove is AB upon BC is equal to the ratio of corresponding intercepts made on any other transversal. That means here the intercepts are PQ and QR. The ratio of it is PQ upon QR. This we want to prove. Therefore, write down as to prove that AB upon BC is equal to PQ upon QR. Now, such ratio AB upon BC or PQ upon QR, we already studied like such ratio in the form in the theorem of BPT, basic proportionality theorem. In the basic proportionality theorem, there is a triangle given to you and a line parallel to any one side of a triangle is also given which intersect the two other sides into different point. But in this figure there is no triangle given to you and hence we want to make the construction that join AR to get the two triangles. When we join this AR, then it intersect the line M in point D. And we will get two triangles ACR and also triangle ARP. First of all, we want to consider triangle ACR. We know that line M is parallel to line N and therefore segment BD is also parallel to the segment CR. This we want to write first. Therefore, write down construction that draw AR, it intersect line M in point D. And we want to start to write to prove. That is, in triangle ACR, segment BD is parallel to CR. Therefore, by BPT, our statement number 1 is AB upon BC is equal to AD upon DR by using basic proportionality theorem. Now, want to consider the another triangle here, triangle ARP. In triangle ARP, AP is parallel to DQ because line L and M are parallel. Then write down ARP, DQ is parallel to AB. And again, using BPT, we want to start from point R here because it is exactly opposite point, which is opposite point of this parallel lines. Therefore, start from R. RQ upon QP is equal to RD upon DA. Write down statement number 2. That is RD upon DA is equal to RQ upon QP by BBT. When we observe the statement number 1 and statement number 2, in the left hand side of statement number 2, it is RD means DR, which is in the right hand side denominator of statement number 1. Again, DA means AD, which is a numerator of statement number 1 in the right hand side. Therefore, we get exactly opposite part in the statement number 2, and hence writing this accurately means RD as DR or AD as DA, and by taking inversion of statement number 2, we will get statement number 3, that is AD upon DR, inverse of statement number 2 is AD upon DR is equal to PQ in the numerator upon QR in the denominator. Now, when we observe the statement number 1 and 3 now, that AB upon BC is equal to AD upon DR, and here AD upon DR is equal to PQ upon QR. This shows that these three ratios are equal. Means statement number 4 is AB upon BC, AB upon BC is equal to AD upon DR is equal to PQ upon QR by using statement number 1, 2 and 3. Then when these three statements are equal, then first and third are also equal. That is AB upon BC is equal to PQ upon QR, which we want to prove here. Thus we get the proof of property of the three parallel lines and their transversal. Now how it is used in the examples? Then consider the example that here the diagram is shown to you, which is a trapezium. In trapezium ABCD, AB is parallel to CD because it is a trapezium. AD and BC are non-parallel sides, and also one segment is drawn which is parallel to this parallel lines, that is PQ is parallel to these two parallel lines, which is given in the question that AB is parallel to PQ is parallel to DC. AP is equal to 15, PD is equal to 12 and QC is equal to 14 given. Then want to find out the value of BQ. We know that these three are the parallel lines, then these non-parallel lines can be considered as a transversals. Therefore, AD is a transversal, BC is a transversal. Then consider AB parallel to PQ, parallel to DC, and therefore by property of three parallel lines, the two ratios are AP upon PD, AP upon PD is equal to BQ upon QC. Only substitute the values which are known to you. That is 15 upon 12 is equal to BQ as it is upon QC. Then by cross multiplication, we will get 12 into BQ is equal to 15 into 4, 14. Then transfer this 12 on the right hand side to get the value of BQ. Now, when 12 goes on the right hand side, it will be divided. Then BQ is equal to 15 into 14 upon 12. By simplifying this, we get the value as BQ is equal to 35 upon 2. Again, by simplifying it, we get BQ is equal to 17.5 units. Thus, we can use the property of three parallel lines in such examples. If you like this video, then like the video and subscribe the channel to get the next video. Thank you.